What I'd love a sense of is how much we're seeing a speed up, how much productivity, and how you measure that at the moment.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. Really exciting times. You know, every company now is a software company. It's not only the big tech, you know, on the West Coast. It's really every bank, every supermarket, every automaker. They all have to write software, so they employ software developers. And what they do is, you know, they're writing code on their machines, and GitHub Copilot predicts that next word, the next line, even multiple lines of code. And so in the last 2 years since we launched GitHub Copilot, we saw that half the code is written by Copilot in those files that's enabled, and it increases productivity of up to 55%. And so we're seeing like the first real use case for AI where a whole sector of the workforce is adopting us to grow productivity.
What's so fascinating is, of course, you're within the Microsoft overall family. So OpenAI has got this relationship. There's also OpenAI Code Interpreter. You've also then got some open source applications sort of coming to the pipeline. We're looking at some exuberance, it feels like, in the developer world for Open Interpreter. Where do you go? Open source, non-open source, OpenAI, GitHub, Open Interpreter? What are the offerings here?
I mean, all of those will be probably covered and cover different use cases. The OpenAI Code Interpreter really helps you with analyzing data. It's really for the Microsoft Excel user to process some data and draw charts and those kind of things. With Copilot and GitHub, and quite frankly, at Microsoft, we've always been a developer tools company. Mm. Microsoft's first ever product was Altair Basic, you know, a basic interpreter almost 48 years ago. And so with GitHub, we're going where the developer is. They're in the editor, they're writing code, they're debugging code, they have to, you know, understand code that comes as far back from the 60s, a programming language called COBOL, all the way to, you know, the modern stack, the cloud native companies that build, you know, the e-commerce world of today. All of them use code to build their innovation.
Thomas, how big a player or contributor is GitHub in the open source AI movement? Do you consider GitHub a leader there?
GitHub is the home of all open source. You know, many, if not the most, the majority of open source projects is hosted on GitHub. And as such, you know, many of those new AI projects are also hosted on GitHub. And GitHub is supporting them by providing them free hosting for their source code, you know, for their project, for their issue tracking, for discussions. And of course, we're enabling them to use GitHub Copilot to build their AI innovation.
Thomas, I speak to all kinds of founders, software engineers about Copilot. Are you able to tell me what specific coding projects are happening with Copilot? And do you track them? Do you have the data that can tell you the specific areas of focus?
So we don't track, you know, at the large scale of what project. That would be a violation of our privacy principles. But for individual organizations, we can show them the data in which repositories, in which projects they are most successful with the use of Copilot. You know, there are certain programming languages like Python or JavaScript that see really strong benefits from the use of Copilot and a lot of lines of code written for these projects.
Meanwhile, boss of Microsoft, Satya Nadella's in Washington, along with an awful lot of other key leaders, thinking about the future of regulation when it comes to artificial intelligence. Are you positive and feeling that that's going to be written well for GitHub to continue to see this evolution on your own platforms?
It's great that these conversations are happening, and we really need to have these conversations happening in Washington because we need the regulation happening fast, right? We need the legal security, the legal safety to apply these tools and get the productivity gains. And think about, like, many companies now have software developers spread around the whole world. You know, they're sitting here in the United States, they're sitting in Germany, in India, in Australia. And so we also need to have regulation that is somewhat equal across these countries, because otherwise, as a software developer myself, as the manager of, you know, thousands of software developers, I don't want my software developers in the United States to have a different productivity gain than those that sit in Germany and those that sit in India, right? We want a balance across all these countries, not a competition between these countries.